Everybody, welcome to the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour, brought to you by Carroll County Fresh, your local sustainable agriculture advocate. I'm your host, Dan Crooks.
I'm Richard Pillay.
How's everybody? And how are you, Richard?
I'm great, Dan. I love this heat. I'm in my element. It must be 155 degrees today.
feels like it, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Well, you may like it. I'm not crazy about it. I have to say that this year I experimented in our community garden, and I grew all heirloom tomatoes. So I got these ugly tomatoes, and I have to say that they are not particularly good in the heat.
Indeed. Well, we, as you know, grow heirloom tomatoes only, and we save seeds. We've been very lucky this year, I guess. We have our own well, so we're able to pump water to it in the evenings, but I shaded the garden with shade cloth early in the season.
Okay.
Last year, I waited until the crops were completely scalded before I shaded it.
Uh-huh.
I did it early this year, and we have a bumper crop of tomatoes, and we're doing very well.
And no bugs, no disease?
So far, with the tomatoes, it's been the best year we've had, in spite of the heat. We do have some squash bug and other kinds of things, but even they're not so bad this year.
Good.
So good.
Well, you know, all of my, you're an experienced gardener. I'm an amateur gardener, and this is, probably the third or fourth year that I've actually paid much attention to growing what I've been eating. I have to say, it's been an education for me. I mean, last year, in a similar way, hot and dry, and I had a wonderful, wonderful crop system of squash and zucchini. This year, almost not. None of them made it because of squash bugs and Japanese beetles and all the rest of it.
And we've had that same issue. Last year was the worst year we've ever had. Year before, quite good. This year, squash, very minimal. We are getting ready to do our fall squash planting. We have seeds started, and we're going to try again. Hopefully, it won't be quite so hot, and we're going to give it another shot. Got one good crop of cucumbers and the like, those kind of things, and did some canning and freezing and what have you.
Well,
every year's an education.
Yep.
And I don't, the more I do this, the less I know.
Well, it feels like that. I belong to a little group called the Ozark Gardeners on Facebook, and our good friend Jim Long from over in Bulleye.
Jim is a real gardener.
Yeah.
And I hope to be as good as he is someday.
Yeah, but he gives good advice, and he will email me every once in a while and let me know what I'm going wrong. Anyways, folks, Richard and I would love to hear some of your gardening experiences. So you can tell us in a couple of ways. You can email your gardening story to us at the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour at gmail.com, or better yet, you can email us and Richard or I will come to your garden and interview you and put your interview on the air. Sounds like a deal?
Sounds like a great deal, Dan, and we'd be glad and really happy to come over to your garden with our little MP3 recorder and see what you're doing, and maybe we can learn something from you.
Yeah, good. Last week we played some mystery musicians, and we asked you to write in if you know who these musicians were. We had a couple of guesses. Mandolina Joy English of Berryville correctly guessed that it was Don Matt and Scott Thompson from their CD Windows of the Soul. And Mandolina, I know you're excited about what you won. It was an all-expense-paid trip to Alpena, Arkansas.
Oh, in the garden spot of Carroll County.
So, Mandolina, you just show up over at the high atop the Grandview Hotel where we record the Ozark Travelers Radio Hour to claim your all-expense-paid trip to Alpena, Arkansas. I will be your chauffeur. So how about that?
Well, Dan, if I would have only been able to enter, had I known. What a surprise.
Yeah. We also had comments in on your AARP editorial on greatness, not meanness. Tell folks about how you recorded that or why you recorded that.
Well, you know, when you get old, like I am, they send you stuff. First, when you're 50, they send you this membership to this codger organization, and you think it's your friends that have done it, and they're giving you a hard time.
Right.
It's a joke. But, but this article in particular struck me that we do need to be civil and have some reverence for our situation and be happier about what's going on.
Uh-huh.
You know?
Uh-huh.
A little bit of honesty and truthfulness and less manipulative power grabbing would be just a really sweet thing. And I thought that article said it in a very nice way.
Well, I think that's right. You know, at the Ozark Travelers Radio Hour, one of our main goals, main purposes, is to build community. You know, we live in this spectacular little part of the world. And we just can't let politicians or bad spirits make us feel worse than we ought to.
And that's true. We do live in a great geographic spot.
Uh-huh.
It's just beautiful country, but more than that, they're great people here.
Mm-hmm.
And part of the Harvest Hour's mission, as you said, is to give these wonderful people a voice.
Right.
And not a voice that's sponsored by some big corporation or has some agenda politically in any way, but just a communication with one another and being able to say, gee whiz, look how great they're doing over there.
That's right. That's right. Well, you know, along those lines, I write for the Carroll County News, and what I have decided to do, I used to write about politics there, but right now I think I'm going to concentrate on doing reviews of cookbooks and good food. That's what's important, I think, right?
Well, it is to us. One of the building blocks of building a good community is local food supply.
That's right.
And as we hear about the tragedies around the world and all of that, you know, knowing that we have a local food supply available is a great comfort.
You bet it is. You bet it is. Also, folks, I'd like you to seek out and find the Eureka Springs Independent. It's a new newspaper published, Templeton, do you know her at all? Anyways, Sandra and Charles Templeton are the publishers of a new newspaper in Eureka Springs called the Eureka Springs Independent. I would like you to find it if you can. If you're an advertiser, have a business, please advertise in that newspaper. And while you're there, please check out my column, In the Pursuit of Happiness. So,
Richard, we have an interesting guest today. I know he'll get right up your nose. He's a pastor of a Christian church in Berryville, a Disciples of Christ congregation. I don't know. Does that ground you off?
Not a bit. I'd be really glad to hear what he has to say. I like the social contract that churches have with the community. You know, the very important part of building a community can be the churches.
That's right. That's right.
And that was the reason why we had this guy. His name is Skip French. On the program. I know that most of our listeners, and many of our farmers, are not church members, and they may have some old tapes and old messages that they've gotten from their youth in the Christian or other congregations that they belong to. And I certainly appreciate and value however anyone expresses their spirituality. The flip side of that is that we live in rural Arkansas in the Bible Belt. There are a lot of really fine folks, including some farmers, some business owners, some friends who do belong to churches.
There are, and it's a great joy to know them all.
Yeah.
And the ones that participate in hatefulness and judgment, and that, I haven't met them.
Uh-huh.
So I couldn't say.
Yeah. So anyways, I had this guy, he's a new pastor in town, and I wanted to find out about what was going on in his head, and the big question was, for me was, how is your little church going to be a part of this community and fulfill your mission of building a community of hope?
Well, I'm interested to hear what he has to say.
Yeah.
Let's listen to it.
All right. Well, I'll tell you what, let's get there now, okay?
Sure.
All right, this is Dan Crooks and
Richard Kelly
on the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour. Stay tuned after this break.